Well, howdy folks, the holidays are coming. I hope you all have happy holidays. And I thought that's the best time to make a kind of refresh video of my Amazon page. I created my Amazon page about 2 years ago, and I have never mentioned it in a video ever since, but it has been in the description under every video. The link to my Amazon page is in all of my videos. Maybe I missed one or two, but if you open a second video, you will certainly find it. Yes, people used to check my Amazon page and appreciate it. And one subscriber, you're not gonna believe it, but completely spontaneously, I had nothing to do with that. He created a video about my Amazon page. Never did I suggest anything to him, completely spontaneous. And he created that video like a long time ago, year and a half ago. And all this time, I never showed you the video. And I should have showed you the video, but I was a little uncomfortable. And then I was always procrastinating. But anyway, he created an awesome video about my Amazon page long time ago. You will believe me that it's a long time ago when you see the video. I'll play the video in a minute now, but the items that he is recommending in the video, you can no longer find on Amazon. They are they have not been in stock in like a year. But at least you can see the stuff that's in my Amazon that used to be on my Amazon page. That is still in my Amazon page. There is other stuff now, but it's still pretty good value. So I'm gonna play the video now. It's kind of funny to see what the world was like year and a half ago. And after you see the video, I'm gonna go to my little office over there, and I'm gonna show you some items that you can still find on my Amazon page today. They are in stock, great prices, and you should take advantage of them while they are still in stock, because 2 years from now, I'm gonna make another Amazon page video, and the stuff that I'll be showing you in my office today will be impossible to find, at least at the prices that I'm gonna show you today.
My name is Tim Beat, and I'm a fan of the iFish YouTube channel and also a correspondent for the Fish Nerds podcast. Nobody does better fishing gear reviews than Victor, and that's why when I buy gear from Amazon, I use the iFish Amazon page. I don't pay any more, and Victor gets a small percentage of my purchase to help support the iFish YouTube channel. It's a great way to say thanks for the time and knowledge Victor shares with us. When I was recently looking for a new ultralight combo, I rewatched all the iFish reviews of rods and reels, and ended up purchasing a Daiwa Exceller LT and a Daiwa Presso 7-foot ultralight fast action rod. I fish for smallmouth bass in rivers and creeks, and I found the combo to be one of the most enjoyable that I've ever owned. It's fun to catch smaller fish with, and it also handles larger fish very well. So if you're purchasing fishing gear on Amazon, make sure to say thanks to Victor by making your purchase through the iFish Amazon page.
You know, when I created my Amazon page, you could go to my page and buy a Daiwa Presso for $55, any size you want. Then you could buy a Daiwa Legalis for $50. I even sold Daiwa Legalis for $45 during the holidays. Nobody cared about that reel before I started pumping it in my videos. And Amazon didn't collect sales tax back then. You could get $105 just the absolute best ultralight combo in the world with free shipping. That was absolutely astonishing value. By the way, if you want to check Tim's podcast, I will leave a link to his podcast in the description box below. Make sure to check it if you listen to podcasts, because I'm telling you honestly, Tim is a sharp guy. He's the guy who recommended these Nico worms to me also. But talking about the incredible value of Daiwa Presso and Daiwa Legalis for $105 shipped, this is an item here that I'm going to show you right now that is very different, but is just the same value, at least today. You know in what kind of world we live today. It's a broken world. I don't want to go there, but I don't approve of anything that is happening right now. But this, in this broken world, this item here, these are Temora jig heads that you can buy on Amazon today for $7 for a full box of these. I don't know if these are 50 or 100. I think they are 50. Maybe they sell 100 piece boxes too. I know they sell with different weights. I have here the 1/32 size. They have the color. They're perfect for tubes or anything that, you know, will use a color. Let me focus here to show you. This jig head is absolutely killer deal, guys. First of all, absolutely perfect shape of the hook. This is a classic shape, cannot be improved. It has the color for hook keeper. If you guys don't want to glue your baits, I glue my baits. I'm not afraid that the glue will spook the fish. But the biggest thing about this hook, other than that it's perfect shape and perfect size, it's not too big. Most of the stuff people use and people sell in Cabela's is too big, man. This hook is crazy sharp. It's just unbelievably sharp. I know it has the typical thick Chinese wire, but this is one sharp hook. You know, I use the highest quality Japanese jig heads in the world. You can check my playlist of Japanese jig heads. I have like a dozen of them, and there is a dozen more coming up. But if I tell you a hook is sharp, this hook is sharp. Here is a comparison. This is the exact same jig head made by Berkley. Okay, looks identical. I'm here to tell you that the Berkley jig heads are made with some stupid dull hooks. And all of the hooks that we'll buy in Cabela's and Bass Pro Shops are dull. I don't know what's the difference. Maybe they're, I don't know, even Eagle Claw hooks, but these hooks are dull. This hook looks like a thick wire. But even you, if you are used to using Japanese jig heads, buy these and tell me that these hooks are not sharp. The battery of my microphone just died, so you are listening this on the iPhone audio right now. Really, the battery life of these microphones is not bad, but I just never charge them. But anyway, this is what I use for my videos, this Rode Go 2. This is what I use. It's on my page also. All of my camera equipment, even the camera that I use, DJI, I use a cheap DJI camera just because it doesn't overheat. I got sick of GoPros overheating and seizing and stopping all the time. But all of my camera equipment is there. But another item I'm going to show you now, let me zoom in here. These are the clips that I use for all of my ultralight fishing. These are super, super small. This is the small size. You will see in my page both the small and the medium, and there is a large size too. But I use the small size for all of my fishing, and I will show you that in a second, how I put them on. You're not gonna put these on a lure on the water, okay? The only way to use this is at home, drinking beer, taking your time, and using some small pliers like this. This is how I put mine. I use, by the way, these pliers are amazing, and you will see them in my Amazon page too. Super smooth and with very thin nose, very, very easy to grab little stuff. But you have to do this at home, when you have time and when you're in a good mood. Just listen to your favorite radio show, drink some beer, and do like 20 of these at once. And then when you go on the water, just use them. I just grabbed these two out of the box. They are not really ready for a video, but these are kind of float lures that I have prepared, and you can see the micro clip here on top, okay, and it's glued and ready to use. When I'm on the water, I just go and tie this baby on under the float, and I can tell you this is just a killer for
any panfish, man. Bluegill, I know the tail is long, but this is just an absolute killer. And I do think the micro clips make a huge difference in float fishing, because when you pull this up and down, it allows for the lure to have a lot more natural kind of action. Without this, it would be moving up and down like this. Now, this is just not natural instead of going up and down. Anyway, I don't want to go there. This is what I use, and I promise you it's highly effective. And the last item I'm going to show you today, because the video is getting long again, is actually a rod. This is a rod by B&M called the TCB. And I actually don't own this rod, and I put it on my Amazon page just because it's recommended by several people who I trust unconditionally. One of which is Randy the Trout Magnet, man. I know most of my subscribers are aware of him. But this rod is actually $5 off today, and it's sold for $65, again, shipped to your door. That's the advantage of buying it on Amazon. Everything else, you know, shipping a rod will be expensive. But if you're looking for a rod to twitch a trout magnet, and you want to support American manufacturers, I know it's not manufactured in America, it's probably designed in America and manufactured in China, but still you're supporting an American brand. Hey, I want to ask you something before I close the video. If you bought something on Amazon, or if you saw something on Amazon that is just a really good quality or a really good deal, if it's a really great buy, please send me an email with a link to that Amazon item, because I want to add it to my Amazon page, and I want to share with people, you know, this holiday, because, you know, everything is out of stock and it's impossible to find something that's a good value. So I want to be sharing, you know, every week or so, whenever I find some great buy on Amazon, I want to be putting these on my community page. So if one of you guys find that something that is just really a great buy, please send me an email so I can share with my community. I will really appreciate that, okay? Thanks for watching this one. Thanks in advance to anybody who decides to buy stuff from my Amazon page. And remember, the most important thing is not fishing, is the family. Bye.